I'm beyond excited to show you this video. This is the ultimate iPhone tips and tricks of all time. I've picked the best ones out of maybe 70, so whether you're a new user or an advanced user, I guarantee this video will be useful and beneficial for you. So let's dive in. Starting with the Wi-Fi password, when you invite your friends over, they will probably ask you, "Can I use the Wi-Fi?" I'm sure that's okay for you, but it's kind of annoying to check the router to see the password. There is an easy way. Go to Settings, then Wi-Fi. Click on the eye icon and tap password. Unlock it, and now you can copy and share. If you double tap the back of your phone, it opens the camera. Triple tap, and it opens the flashlight. Back tap is super useful, as you can choose pretty much any command. In my case, when I double tap, it triggers the back key. And triple tap opens ChatGPT. To set it up, go to Settings, then Accessibility, then Touch. Scroll down to the bottom and select Back Tap. From there, you can choose whatever you like. If you prefer my way, choose Home for double tap, and for triple tap, Shortcuts, ChatGPT. I will talk about shortcuts later in this video. Now let's move on to scanning notes and texts. The Notes app is super powerful. Let me show you. Open Notes and tap the camera icon. Click on Scan Text to scan any text you like. It instantly scans the text and adds it to your notes. How about this? You can easily e-sign PDFs on your iPhone. Long press on Notes, then select New Note. Tap the markup icon, followed by the plus icon. Then click on Add Signature. You can create your signature using a stylus or your finger. So, open a PDF, tap the plus icon, and add your signature by tapping on it. Then, you can adjust the size like this. If you are a content creator or a casual photo editor, this feature is a must use. Just tap and hold on to the picture you want to cut out. Then click Tap Share and save the image. Now you have an awesome PNG image in your photo gallery. Or, simply, you can hold the image and drag it anywhere you like. How cool is that? This is an iOS 17 feature, but you can create a sticker like this. Did this happen to you too? When you are working on something or typing, you accidentally end up clicking the delete button. Don't worry, just shake your phone. Then tap undo. Did you know this? Pinch in to copy. Pinch out to paste. Triple tap to highlight and select all sentences. Also, if you own multiple Apple devices, this is also quite useful. Copy text on iPhone, then you can paste on iPad or MacBook. Sometimes, you make a typo in messages or send a message to the wrong person. Or is it just me? Anyway, simply tap and hold down the message you didn't mean to send, and tap Undo Sent.
Wow.
Then, tap and hold down the message again. Now you can edit and correct the sent message. This feature is quite fun to use. Long press on the blue send icon for options like slam, loud, gentle, invisible ink. You can also click on the screen for exciting visuals like spotlight, balloons, confetti, heart, discoteca vibe, and fireworks. I bet you will appreciate this trick. Do you check your flight status on the board? No need. Just send your flight number. Tap the message and preview the flight. When you want to listen to music while falling asleep but don't want unwanted music to wake you up, use this feature. The iPhone timer has a useful feature for this. Once you set the timer, tap it. Click when timer ends and scroll down. Tap stop playing. Once the timer reaches its set time, the music will also stop. This works with YouTube videos too. Lately, phones are getting bigger and bigger, and you need both hands to use them comfortably. If you still want to type something with one hand, long press the globe icon. It gives you an option to slide the keyboard to the left or right side, making it easier to type with one hand. Did you know that if you hold down the space bar, it activates the trackpad mode? This helps with precise control when selecting texts. I think most people use Google Maps, but this feature from Apple Maps is quite useful. Long press the map and click Mark My Location. This will mark a pin at your current location. So, even if you walk for a couple of hours and forget where you parked your car, it's okay. Just open the map and start directions. You can easily go back there because you marked the pin.
Starting walking. Arrived.
When you want to quickly return to the top of a page or list while scrolling down in an app, tap the clock icon. Again, if you want to quickly go to the top of the screen, tap the clock. Also, if you want to scroll down to the bottom, tap the library icon. If you enjoyed the video so far, please consider subscribing. That way, you won't miss out on the iOS 17 tips and tricks in the future. If you hand over your phone to your kids, use this feature. Because you can lock your device or disable certain things. Let me show you. When you enable guided access, you can use and play within the app, but can't exit from the app. To turn it off, triple-click the power button again and enter your passcode or use face unlock. If you are a parent, you know how useful this is. You can control your phone without Siri. Say open ChatGPT. Open camera. Take a picture. Switch to selfie. Do you like it? Okay, so go to settings. Then accessibility. Scroll down to accessibility shortcut. Tap voice control. I will explain more in the description. When you share pictures or something, you get these contact suggestions. I don't like it. You can long press each contact one by one to suggest less, but there is a way to completely stop this. Go to settings. Tap Siri and search. Scroll down to suggestions from Apple. And turn off show when sharing. Do you sometimes move apps and organize your home screen? When you do, this might save you time. Long press an app until it starts wiggling. While holding it, tap the other apps you want to move. And then release them. You can also use the same trick to select and share multiple photos. Want to share a screenshot without cluttering up your photo library? Take a screenshot, then tap on it. Now, instead of sharing, tap Done. Click Copy and Delete. Paste the screenshot wherever you want. It won't show up in your photo gallery. This way, it won't take up space on your phone. We all use our phones even in low light conditions, which may cause insomnia, right? At least turn on the night shift. Go to settings, tap display and brightness, and turn on night shift. You can adjust the color temperature. This might help improve your sleep quality. While you are using apps, do you receive these notifications? To block them, go to settings. Tap App Store. Turn off in-app ratings and reviews. Do you use this app? It's underrated but invaluable. It's simple. You can measure and level with your iPhone. Quite handy. Shortcuts are amazing. It's kind of like Android in some ways. I created these four simple ones. When I tap Navigate to Home, it not only quickly opens Google Maps but also shows me the directions to my home. Tap Send Messages. This is pretty handy too. Just one tap, and the message I created is ready to send. Even driving, I can tell my wife I'll be home in 10 minutes. You know Shazam. When you are at a cafe, drinking a cappuccino, you hear a song. Cool, what song is this? Shazam can identify the song for you. And this is ChatGPT. Automation allows your iPhone to complete tasks for you, making things easier by saving time and effort. In my case, I set up this one. When I charge my phone, it says,
"Thank you. Thank you."
To set it up, open Shortcuts and Automation and tap the plus button. Create personal automation and scroll down to select charger. Next, add the action. Type speak text. You can use any phrase. Tap the blue arrow to adjust the pitch and rate. You can also change the voice and turn off ask before running. All right, it's ready. You can split the screen into two like this. To find it out, please watch this video. If you enjoyed the video, please sub and share this with your friends and family. Thank you for watching. See you next time.